Once you have full sets of landmarks for each specimen in your data set, you'll probably want to export these landmarks from Slicer in order to do further analyses in programs like Geomorph and R. There are a few different ways you can go about this. I'll be demonstrating three here. So the first method you can use is to run the Procrustes analysis in Slicermorph and then take the Procrustes landmarks that it exports and import those into R. So to do this, we will go to the geometric morphometrics portion of Slicermorph and the GPA module, which stands for generalized Procrustes analysis. I'm going to select just a few very basic landmark files that I created for an example. We'll create an output directory, which I'm just gonna let default here. And then I want to execute my GPA. So you can, as always, explore the results using the tools in Slicermorph here. But the part we care about right now is actually going to the folder where we saved. So now that we've done that, we will find this folder in that directory with the date and time, and you'll see a list of files, CSV files, that you can easily access. The ones we care about are primarily going to be the output data. So if I actually open that and look at it, what these are the Procrustes coordinates for each specimen. And most of the time, this should be fine. You can just run the Procrustes analysis in Slicer and then import those into another program directly like R. Geomorph plays really well with this type of formatting. So normally this method works pretty well, but if you want to do sliding of the landmarks along with Procrustes, you'll need to export the raw landmarks before you can do that. So in order to do this, we're gonna get a little bit more complicated. So the first method I'm going to show is using the Slicermorph R library in R to import FCSVs or mark.jsons into R. So this is nice because either format works and it will put it directly into R. So if you're using Geomorph, you have it there. The Slicermorph R package is only available on their GitHub. So you have to use this special line of code to install it, but then you can just call it like any other library. And you can see here, I've got my working directory set. I'm calling for all of the files in the directory that are FCSVs, which is the type of landmark file that I'm working on. I'm making an empty array that has five landmarks, three dimensions, and three specimens. That's my little sample data set. And then I'm grabbing the file names to use as basically the specimen label. Once I've got the file paths and the file names, I can just run through all of them and add them to that empty array that I made. And then I can name all of the arrays with the specimen name and XYZ coordinate, which is what this code is doing here. So this isn't a method I've used a lot personally, since I actually didn't know about this package until recently, but it seems to be very nice. But also I was using Mathematica, so I had to do some external formatting to get a more generalized format for my landmarks. The other thing I will point out is that Slicer landmark files seem to change formatting occasionally in ways that can break these type of functions. So there is a read FCSV function that is baked into Geomorph, but it doesn't appear to be working currently, probably because of how the format has changed between versions. But as of now, this Slicermorph R format or reading function works pretty well. So a third method you can use is the Python code I developed to more generally format landmarks coming out of Slicer. This code is specifically designed to format landmarks in this way, where each in a table, each specimen is a single row, and then each column is a coordinate. So, and these are labeled like X1, Y1, Z1, and then X2, Y2, Z2, etc. for however many landmarks you have. The advantage of this is a format that works not only for Geomorph and R, but also the Mathematica packages made by David Pauly, and is usually what people like to share their landmarks as if they are publishing and sharing the landmarks as part of supplementary information. So I really like this formatting because I find it easier to work with. And you can eventually get to this if you are importing directly into R via SlicerMorph. But as I said, I didn't know about that package. So I figured I'd make my Python code for doing this available for anyone who's interested. So the way that my process works is I put all of the landmark files, and they specifically have to be the FCSV format, into a folder with only the merge landmarks Python script that I have available on my GitHub. So there should be nothing else in the folder. And the first step we have to do is actually convert these FCSVs to CSVs. This is very straightforward to do from the command prompt in Windows. First, I have to change my file directory to the folder that I'm currently in. And once I do that, I'm going to run this command that will rename every FCSV extension to CSV. And you can see they all converted right there. You do want to be very careful that you are doing this in the folder that you have your FCSVs in and not any other folder, because you don't want to be changing file extensions that shouldn't be changed. Once you do that, it's time to run the Python script. So I just double click on the script for it to run. You'll be prompted if you want to change the directory, so you can type in the correct directory if you need to, but I don't need to, so I'm just going to say no. Strip the first two lines is specific to if you have not run the script before on these files. So I do need to strip the first two lines. If the script has already been run on these files and you need to run it again for some reason, you would want to say no. And then I need to specify the number of landmarks, which in this case is 5. What that's going to output is this landmarks.csv file. And if I open it up, it doesn't have headers because I'm kind of lazy in my coding. So I just name this first column label, and then the next columns X1, Y1, Z1. And then I can just drag this out and it will automatically rename all of those columns headers so they match up with what R and other packages expect. I'll save this, and then this file is done. Now, the other thing you might want to do is convert landmarks back into Slicer, which I also have a script for called Unmerge Landmarks. And the reason I've wanted to do this is primarily to check on how my semi-landmarks are sliding and what that looks like in Slicer, and also use the SlicerMorph tools to visualize my landmarks after I've done some things to them in R. So if you're in that position and you would like to export landmarks from R into Slicer, you will need a data set that is formatted like this landmarks file I just showed, and it should be called landmarks.csv. So it should look like this. And you will put this in a folder with my unmerged landmarks Python script and an FCSV template. This is available on my GitHub as well, but I essentially made it by creating a FCSV in Slicer with the number of landmarks I needed, and then making all of the landmarks just this 0.1. So if you're using it, you may need to add more It's set to 158 right now. I only need it at as 5, so I'm just going to delete these rows, save it. And then, like before, I'm just going to double-click the unmerge landmark file. That directory is correct, so I'm not going to change the directory. It's 5 landmarks. And now you'll see 3 CSV files appear. These do have to be converted back to FCSVs to be imported into Slicer, but that again is just as simple as changing my directory to this folder using the command prompt, and then renaming all CSVs to FCSV. It also did it to these 2 files, but I could easily rename them back. And so now these are directly importable into Slicer.